He was a man that hid from nothing. At times, the mere mention of his name would get you instant access to certain places and immediately kicked out of certain others. Nothing seemed out of his grasp.
He had more confidence and belief in me that he could be president. I never believed I could be president, but he believes he could be president.
From birth, Alex Derland was destined for greatness.
Is this going to be serious?
He's once rumored to have the brakes removed from everything he owned because he refused to slow down.
Words to describe Alex Derland: cool, crazy, awesome, cool.
His wild ride to the razor's edge of sanity catapulted him towards the bright lights of immortality.
And we're like going, oh dude, that dude's f***ing crazy.
But the rise to glory can bring you too close to the sun. And as Alex sped up in his race to the top, things began to spiral out of control.
I mean, I didn't think a guy could get that low, and I just couldn't believe it.
Somehow, through a series of hard work, miracles, and finding love, he was able to regain control and aim for the top once again. Behind the Music presents Alex Derland.
As a kid,
can you describe a childhood as devastating without it being like bad?
Yeah, you can do that. It was devastating, but in a good way.
It was like, ah, devastating.
It was a good devastating.
Yeah.
Alex Derland was born in 1981. To parents Bob and Christy Derland. Some say he was born to party. His free spirit and rock and roll attitude could be seen from a young age. At the age of 6, armed only with the reading level of a kindergartner, Alex decided to run away from home to experience what the world had to offer.
Are Alex?
Ray Alex, Mom?
I don't think so.
At the time, he convinced Zeke, his younger brother of 2 years, to travel with him.
I was 6. Why not?
Zeke made it to the end of the driveway before turning back.
I was 6. I mean, I could barely tie my own shoes, let alone go along with these crazy ideas that Alex is coming up with. Hey, Zeke, let's live in a cardboard box in a subway station. Or, hey, Zeke, let's live in a trash can. Hey, Zeke, let's mow grass for money. Or better yet, let's kidnap a kid. I mean, things get out of control fast.
He made a change right... Oh, hold on, he's thinking about it. Yeah, we just turned eastbound. We're about to go underneath the 5. You want to go ahead and give us back?
Eventually, the fast-paced street life began to bore Alex, and he decided to return home after a heartfelt plea from his younger sister, Katie.
I just was begging him to please come back and just finish elementary school, because he just wasn't going to have anything to do with his life if he didn't just finish elementary school.
In the 4th grade, Alex entered an event that would impact his life forever. The 4th grade geography beat.
I got a million ways to get it.
We were so bad. He was so excited.
That
was
great.
Academic cool, right?
His coaches were there. There were foreign diplomats for some reason. I mean, there was tons of fans screaming. There was blood. Teacher was crying. I mean, that thing was intense.
I heard about this 4th grade geography bee. He claimed to be the champion. Of course, can't be proven. Nobody's ever seen a trophy or a ribbon or anything.
Alex emerged victorious.
Alex is definitely a fun person to hang out with after being on that geography bee, because he just seemed to know everybody, and everybody seemed to know him.
The fame and power that came from Geography B soon began the media's international love affair with Alex and set him on his course towards greatness.
Everyone just wanted a piece of Alex.
Oh yeah, and somewhere in there, Ethan was born.
No one ever tells me anything.
Oh, this interview's about Alex Derlin? Yeah, I know Alex. How do you forget a guy who won the fourth grade geography bee?
The pressures of living up to the title of Jeffries Grove fourth grade geography bee champion followed him into middle school. But Alex soon found an outlet for his competitive spirit on the soccer field.
Alex was a pretty good soccer player at the beginning, and then he got more and more into it. We were glad it ended when it did.
As his soccer talents progressed, he began to gain a reputation.
Back in the day when he played soccer with Alex, he was a basher.
And sought out not just to win, but to punish the competition.
Finally, one game, things just snapped, and you can never go back from there. Yeah, guys, here
good
we
work,
go.
Good work.
Let's all have fun out there.
See some hustle.
Come on.
Here we go. Teamwork, yeah. That's all about.
Yeah, we're all having fun.
Here
we're all
go.
Having
yeah.
fun.
Good work. Nice hustle,
go.
Jake.
Yeah.
Go,
go get him, Alex.
There
come
go,
on, Alex.
Alex.
Easy, oh, Alex. Oh, easy. Oh, oh, my God. God. Oh,
shit.
Mama. Oh, stop it. No, we don't do that. We don't do that. There's blood everywhere.
There's blood. Make it stop. Oh, Jesus.
Like, blood was going everywhere. And, yeah, you did not want to get in front of Alex's shot.
Soon, Alex was banned from all competitive sports for life. Putting this phase of his life behind him, Alex looked ahead to high school for a fresh start.
Yeah, I know Alex from high school. We had some good times together. I played a game called football in high school.
But Alex couldn't play sports. Because of his ban, he began to seek out new hobbies, like cheerleading, the Fine Gentlemen's Club, joining a militia, and volunteering with special needs children, until finally Alex discovered a passion that would stick with him for life, physical therapy.
Alex and physical therapy was definitely a huge passion of his. All he wanted was people to get hurt so that he could take care of them and make them better.
College recruiters would come around from all over just to watch Alex do physical therapy. I mean, the games would be packed.
Guys in the stands, he would have signs for Alex, best physical therapist. Alex, way to rehab my son. Alex, Alex, Alex. I'm like, I'm on the field. Who is this Alex guy? Go back to sitting on the bench and walk in the halls and be the physical therapist.
Yeah, dude, I mean, you walk around and like, be able to touch girls, he'd be like, hey, I'm gonna be a physical therapist one day, can I practice on you? He's kind of like his own version of a doctor.
Yeah, it was actually kind of weird. Like, he kind of like touched it. Weird spots like my knees, my elbows.
That dude would work you out, man. Cold baths, hot tubs. He's the man. Ice packs. That's why we call him Ice Pack Derlin.
Upon graduation, Alex was dead set on bypassing school and instead competing in a new national TV singing competition.
We had no idea what was involved, and neither did he.
In fact, we didn't even know the child could sing.
And neither did they.
Well, you look a little odd. Your dancing is terrible. The singing was horrendous. And you look like one of those creatures that live in the jungle with those massive eyes. What are they called? Bush baby.
You are so
okay, Randy.
It's a no, man, but I enjoyed you, man. It was funny, dude.
I think you're awesome. Not right for this competition, but I think you're awesome.
Alex was eliminated from competition, his spot instead given to his longtime friend, Clay Aiken. Alex had decided it had become time to pursue other interests and head off to college.